All right. Dr. Anthony Greco is one of our prominent citizens, a physician here in town, a dermatologist. Dr. Greco and I visited a few days ago on the telephone. I really didn't have time to get acquainted with him. But I found out that Dr. Greco is originally from Canada, has practiced medicine in Canada, and came to the United States for a better system. Dr. Anthony Greco.
Thank you, everybody. I came to the States when I was 29 years old. I was born and raised in a place called Sault Ste. Marie, Canada, which is a border town. It's on the border of the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. I'm board certified both in the United States and in Canada in dermatology. And when I finished my training, I came to Texas. So my perspective on healthcare may be a little different than a lot of folks because I was actually in both systems. Both as a physician and as a patient. If you listen to the media nowadays, it's very one-sided. You're only getting the happy, rosy picture of socialized single-payer medicine. I can't recall an editorial that I've read that actually is a negative on this, so I'm going to give you my experiences on it. Everybody probably has a different view on this, and it's a pretty complicated issue, so I'm going to try and be really, really brief here. But if anybody wants any more information, they can always get in touch with me. I'm easy to get in touch with. The three things that you need to be aware of in single-payer, government-run healthcare are taxes, no options, and rationing, I should say. I'm going to touch on taxes briefly because I think that's pretty obvious. In Canada, the average Canadian pays between 55 and 60% taxes. Plus, they also pay 15% at the register when they buy any goods and services. Now, that's quite a bit more than what we pay here in Texas. I would estimate, and the government estimates, about 15 to 20% of that tax is healthcare related. So if we're going to go to a single-payer government-run system, be prepared to be paying about 15 to 20% more in taxes in addition to more money at the register. The government is already talking about a VAT, or what's called the goods and services tax. They're already talking about it now. And the fact is the money is not going to be there to pay for the $1 trillion cost that we're going to have in the next 10 years if we go this route. So we're talking probably, in my estimate, probably 15 to 20% goods and services tax at the register, I would think. And they're going to hide that into the things. They're not going to make you pay it. They're going to hide it in the prices. That's how they're going to get it through to you. So number one, taxes. Number two, options. Canadians actually, in my hometown, have it pretty good. Because when they want services, they go to Michigan to get them. If somebody needs a breast biopsy, they're not going to wait 8 weeks to get it. They're going to go to the doctor in Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan, have their biopsy, and go back to Canada with the results with it. Similarly with prostate treatments. If you get diagnosed with prostate cancer and you got to wait 16 weeks for your treatment, a lot of them will go across the river to Michigan, have their treatments done. It's just a quick ride across the bridge. And my family's done it. A lot of my friends and folks that I know in Sault Ste. Marie do that. It's very, very common. You will not have that option because the United States is the last country here that has the system we have. Everybody here is going to have a Medicaid coverage. If you want to pay for your services, you will not be allowed to. The Canadian Medical Act states you cannot pay cash for any medical treatment that's covered under Medicaid. So that's the option that will be taken away from you. So if you discover a lump in your breast or a spot on your leg or a spot in the groin and you need to have it checked and you have to wait 8 weeks, well, tough, you have to wait 8 weeks. You can't go across the river to Michigan or you can't go across, you know, the border to get some treatment done because the government won't allow it. You wait in line with everybody else. And some people may think that's a good system. I happen not to be one of those. The third thing is rationing of care. Rationing has to deal, I guess, more with the taxes. That'll happen. The government sets out strict criteria for diagnosing and treating diseases. If you don't fall into those 10 criteria, you're out of luck. If you're 82 years old and you've got prostate cancer, you've got to live with it. And it's not just prostate cancer. There's a lot of other conditions that have strict guidelines as to treatment. And if you don't fall into those treatment guidelines, you don't get treatment. Now, again, Canadians have the option of just going over the border and getting their treatment, and they love that. But that option's going to be taken away. So there's going to be a lot of long lines waiting for treatment. When I worked in the emergency room, the average wait there was 12 to 24 hours just to get seen. There were no beds, so most folks laid on gurneys in the hallways. That's the average emergency room if you walk into one in a bigger city in Canada. There's just lots of gurneys and a lot of sick folks lying around. That's not the type of system that I want. So be prepared for those big three things. We're talking high taxes, no options, and rationing of healthcare. And you don't hear about that in the media because nobody wants to talk about that. That's the dirty secret that they're not telling you. And the Canadian government said this to Canadians back in the early 40s and 50s when they implemented their Medicare system. They were telling you exactly the same thing as what the government's telling you right now. And as the costs escalate, because medical treatments now there's a lot more advances, a lot more expensive treatments, a lot more scanning systems. These things aren't cheap. Costs are going up and up and up. How are they going to get those costs that paid for? They're going to have to tax it out of you. And number one, they're going to have to ration the care, which means only a select few are going to be able to use the services. So the funny thing about a lot of this too is the Canadians, you hear a lot of great stories about how happy Canadians are with their health care. But the fact is, two of the seven provinces in Canada are already reverting to an American system. The provinces of Alberta and Quebec. They're already allowing cash for services, and it's a big, big political issue up there right now. But Canadians aren't as happy as you think with their health care. And they've got the option of coming to the U.S. for treatment and diagnosis. We're going to take that option away, not only from us, but from everybody else, too. So there's a lot of things you need to know before you go down that road for single-payer universal government-run healthcare. It's a big, big bureaucracy, a lot of taxes, a lot of corruption. I'm very opposed to it. There's a lot of differing points of view on this. You can hear them all, but I wish the media were a little more fair and balanced about this sort of thing, because we're not hearing the full picture. And I noticed a lot of the editorials in the paper, they'll cherry pick somebody who went to Canada for 4 weeks and got great health care. That's great, but talk to the other 99% who are sitting in lines waiting for diagnosis and treatment. Those folks, you never hear from them. So just look at all sides of this issue. It's a pretty complicated issue, and I'm trying to be as brief as I can with it. Call your congressman, call your senators, get as much detail as you can on it, and talk to folks who work in the system like I did. I was a patient and a doctor in the system. And get lots of points of view, and you're heading down a road for big bureaucracy and a lot of taxes. And I just think it's a poor standard of healthcare, I personally do. So anyhow, that's my remarks in brief. Give me a call if you want some more information on it. I'm happy to talk to anybody about the system. And I just hope the media is a little more fair on the issue down the road, too. Thanks. Yeah.